This program fuses magic, suggestion, psychology, misdirection, and showmanship. I achieve the results you'll see through a varied mixture of those techniques. At no point are actors or stooges used in the show. This is Port Merion in North Wales, where the cult TV series The Prisoner was filmed back in the 60s.
His whole sort of colouring seems to change, and the eyes were piercing all the time. The eyes were very, very, very intense.
And these are the rules for a staring competition. The first person to look away or blink loses the game.
Guy in the baseball cap? To me. What's your name?
I'm Jamie.
Jamie, come sit here for me. Look at me. Yeah, you'd be good at this. Go. What's up?
I just don't feel right.
You don't feel right?
No.
Do you want to stop?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Anyone else?
After a while, I started getting this nasty feeling deep down, sort of in my stomach area, right up to my throat. It just felt as if he had, like, some type of control over me.
Could you come round for me? Excellent. And come and stand just here. Brilliant. Ready? Go. Stop. You want to stop? Look at me, look at me, look at me, look at me. Take a deep breath. And relax, and it goes.
My eyeballs felt to be burning. I got this sort of feeling in my head, this sort of pounding in my temples. They're really pounding right across here. Excuse me a minute. And I just felt... It was a feeling of intense terror. But it wasn't a terror, I wasn't going to run away from it. I was just going to knock the living shite out of him, basically. That was the feeling. That's as close as I can express it. The adrenaline was really going, my heart felt like I could feel it pumping. There was just something there that was really, really menacing. I couldn't say exactly what it was. There was something unknown.
There's an old and obscure psychic feat of apparently seeing with your fingertips. And a few people even to this day do claim to have this ability. I can certainly achieve the same results, but through methods I don't believe to be psychic.
Well, thank you very much for coming along to this vintage eyeglass emporium. Now, you may or may not know that I'm a huge fan of the whole area of Victorian charlatanism. There was a girl from that period, a 15-year-old girl, called Lillian Keeble, flaming red hair. She toured the houses of rich people with a parlour act, which she called dexterous vision. And what Keeble claimed... was that she could see through the fingertips, these two fingertips here of her right hand. Now, I'm a huge fan of her, and I've dug and dug for information on her. She's not that well known about, and sort of come up with bits and pieces, allow me to piece together what her methods may have been. This is why I've asked you here. So, the first thing that she would do in her act was as follows. Can I maybe try this with you, Michael? Can I just swap places with Michelle? I'll ask you to come around here. All right. Now, she would ask somebody to write down a sentence or a phrase. Now, this is entirely up to you what you write, OK? I'm going to get you to write it down on this piece of card. If you take those for me... Now, obviously, it's very important I don't see what you write, so wait till I've turned away. But anything you like, a phrase or a short sentence. I'll face away while I do it. Don't let anyone see. Tell me when you're done.
Yeah.
OK, and just hold the card like that between your... hands like this so I can turn around safely and not see it.
Sure.
Is that safe? Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Michelle, can I bring you back round here again, this side? If you come and stand here. Now, your point of view here, Michelle, is just to make sure that I'm not going to cheat or turn and look. So you're essentially going to hold my gaze. Uh-huh. All right, so you know I'm not going to look away. All right. Now, Michael, what I want you to do is to hold the card, so the card is flat, but writing side down.
Yeah.
And if you come around here just a little bit so that I can put my hand... All right. I'm not going to touch the card. Now, what's interesting about her methods, of course, is this is 1845, all right? They were simple, but weirdly, the word big, is that right? A big?
Yeah.
Hell to, maybe that's hello, a big hello. Is this right? Am I close?
No,
yeah,
that's right.
A big hello to all matching. Or watching, even. A big hello to all watching. Can you show the camera? Am I... Let's have a look. What does it say? A big hello to all watching. Thank you so much. I'll ask you to go stand back there again.
There's no human possible way that he could do that. Well, he is a human. But it's not normal.
The highlight of the act for me was when Lillian would give her abilities to somebody else. So, Michelle, I'll do this with you. If you can just come around here for me and point those two fingers for me like that. Now, keep your other fingers in. Now, look at me. I'm going to give you the ability that Lillian had. You'll be able to see with your fingertips. Just press your two fingers up against mine. You will be able to do it. You must believe that. Look at me. You must believe that. Good. Okay, keep your fingers like that. Don't move them. Now I'm going to write down... We'll keep it relatively simple. A two-digit number. All right? I will write this behind my back so you can't even catch a glimpse of anything or the movement of my arms or anything that might give it away. All right? A two-digit number. That's all I'm going to tell you. All right, and I'll ask you just to... It's there. It's written just there. All right? So if you keep your fingers there, you are underneath where the number is written. So all you've got to go on is your instinct now. So imagine perhaps a white screen and allow the image of a number to appear on it. It is a two-digit number.
32.
Some reason, why did you say 32?
I don't know.
Okay, it is...
Oh, my God! Oh, my God! That's amazing. I'm physically shaking.
You are physically shaking.
That was just weird, is the only way to describe it. Because I could actually see it in my head, the way he'd written it. It was just, I mean, tears came to my eyes emotionally. It was just very strange. Absolutely amazing. Don't know how he does it.
Cardiff, lovely place. She lives there. And home of the reasonably famous Cardiff Market. Here I am casually mixing with the locals and playing a game where they can win some money and I can look revoltingly clever.
Have you got a wallet on you or a purse or some money?
Yes.
Can I just see? Don't show me how much money you got, but just show me what you keep your money in. Excellent. Have you got any loose change in you as well, or is everything in there?
Everything in there.
Everything's in there. All right, so here's the game. I'm going to try and tell how much money you've got in that wallet.
Yes.
If I'm more than 50 pence out, you win £100. Right? £5 £20 notes. You don't have to put any money in it yourself, so you've got nothing to lose, apart from your dignity. So, let me ask you a few questions. You work here, obviously?
Yes.
Do you drive in? Do you walk in?
Catch a bus.
Okay, great. Do you go shopping on the way home?
Sometimes.
Okay, married? No.
No.
Are you in a rush to get to work in the morning?
Usually, yes.
Okay, all right. I'm going to write down an amount and put it in this envelope, all right? Don't look, because it'll spoil the surprise. Look at me. Okay. Okay, hang on to that for me. Great, thank you. Will you please count the amount of money you've got? Tell us how much you got.
I've got £30 of notes.
Yeah, keep going, there's some more.
35, 50, 70, 80, 90, 36.
36, yeah.
And 35 pence.
£36, 35p, and some that.
My lucky stone.
All right. £36, 35p. Yep.
Yep.
Put the rest of the money back in the wallet.
Right.
I think I'm all right. First of all, it's very important that none of us had asked you how much money you had on you.
No.
The exact money was £36.
35 pence.
35p. Have a look. It says...
£36.31.
£4 off, which leaves me safely from the 50 pence limit. Thank you very much indeed.
I can't believe that. I was a bit gutted because I thought he wasn't going to get it, to be honest with you. There's no way anybody could have known what was in my purse. No, I didn't even know what was in my purse, so, yeah. I just can't believe he got it, to be honest with you. Can't believe it.
In part two, I meet Ninja.
Inside my head now is chaos.
And we get to play with Simon.
I'm stunned.
Okay, you have a wallet on you?
I have.
Okay, will you show me where it is? Just don't take it out, but...
There.
Is that inside pocket?
All right.
I'm going to go into here, but I'm going to keep looking at you. I will take nothing, but I'll tell you everything, as Keeble used to say.
Right.
And you hold my gaze there, that's a black wallet. All right. There's silver, a silver card, and a blue card. The silver card maybe is Yeah, it's a Visa card. I can see the Visa symbol. All right. That's a fiddly... it's a receipt. Okay, that looks like a cab receipt. 28th. Maybe that's the date. Maybe that was on the 28th that you used that. It's for £10. It's a £10 cab receipt. There is... So I'm trying to get everything back. There's a book of stamps. You have two missing. You've taken two out, and there's a folded paper in there. Money, I take it. There's... No, it's not. There's no money in there. You've got no money in your wallet. It looks like a shopping list. Apples. Bananas. Oranges. And loo roll. Lovely. OK, I'm going to ask you to take that out and verify everything I've said. Let's have a look.
I certainly have the stamps. Two missing.
Two missing.
There's a Visa card.
9009, I think. The last figure. You might need to turn it over.
9009.
Let's have a look.
Extraordinary.
There was a blue card. These are the two that I was seeing.
Tesco shopping card.
All right, okay.
That's the taxi receipt.
Let's have a look.
That's quite extraordinary. I don't know how you knew that.
There's the 28. It says number 28. I thought number that was a date. 28, and it's for £10. Can we see that? Can we just get all this?
I don't know how you do it.
And what else did I mention? The card.
Coffee mist. Oranges. Bananas. Marvel.
Apples. Oranges. Bananas. Some less savoury items. I'm delighted.
I am astonished, I have to admit.
Thank you so much for doing that. Thank
what
you.
Amazed me most was the taxi card. Until this morning, I was going to come by car. So nobody knew I had a taxi receipt in my car, in my wallet. I did not know myself that the number 28 was written on that receipt. I'm completely, utterly baffled beyond my comprehension how this is done.
I'm going to try and tell you how much money you've got on you. I'll get within 50p of it, or if I don't, you win £100. OK? Excellent. All right. So, let me ask you a few questions. How did you get here today?
Bicycle.
By bicycle. All right, OK. OK, if you went out for a meal, how much would you spend, roughly, per head?
30 quid.
30 quid, all right, reasonable. All right, great. And do you drive?
No.
No. Okay, all right. Okay, I'll try and get as close as I can. So within 50p or even 100 quid. Don't look. I'll scribble something down there. Okay, you hold on to that for me. Will you count your money? Take your time.
£3.
So what's that?
331.
331. What you got in there? Just 10. So it's £13.31. I said I'd get within 50p. Have a look. It's actually
£13.31.
It's spot on. I'm quite proud of that one. Well done, mate. Cheers. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you very much.
Oh my gosh. Inside my head now is chaos. It's obliterated. I can't see how he has done it. I'm gobsmacked.
Imagine if instead of trying to work out what your complicated friends want for their birthdays, you could just go out and get whatever you like and then convince them that that's what they want. Life would be so much easier.
If you come and take a seat just over here,
that'd be great.
Just there.
Just here.
Thank you very much. Excellent. So, we spoke on the phone a few days ago.
Yes.
And I asked you to write down something you'd like for your birthday.
Yes.
It also asked you to sign the back of it when I spoke to you and gave you these instructions, so that basically when you brought it with you today, which I hope you have done, you know that no one's going to steam it open or switch it or do anything with it.
Absolutely.
All kept secret?
Very much so.
Excellent. All right.
Well, I have bought you a present.
Now, don't get overexcited. It is in the big box behind you.
Right.
Right. It may be a small present in a big box.
Right.
Or it may be a big present in a big box.
Okay.
The size of the box will not necessarily give you any clues.
Sure.
All right. When you walk into a shop and you see something that you know you have to have, mm-hmm. what is that feeling like? Describe it for me.
I guess it's quite sort of sudden, and you sort of you have a definite positivity about it. And often you'll go away and see other things, but then you come back to the thing you saw first. And
excellent.
It's like, you know.
Well, just take that feeling. I just sort of amplified a bit for me, because it is a really good feeling. It's important to understand that feeling of positivity that
sure.
you describe. Okay. And also, very nice to meet you, and thank you for coming on the show. Let me explain to you how I buy gifts or presents for people, all right? And this is the best way to handle, bar none, the problem of, you know, what to settle for when you're going to buy gifts for somebody that's a little bit difficult to buy for, all right? Now, what I do is, rather than recycle the same sort of two tired bottles of wine or box of chocolates, which are no fun to receive, I go out and I buy anything, and then I make that person fall in love with it, all right, by creating a strong feeling of desire for that object. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. And it absolutely works. They get all sort of pumped up, you know, they get that feeling of that positivity you were describing. They beam excitement for it. And, you know, it's a win-win thing, because they get a present that they love, and, you know, I get rid of some stuff out the back of my kitchen cupboard or whatever. What I want you to really understand about this, because it's important, is that that feeling is so strong, can be so extreme, that it can replace the memory of what they actually wanted. So even though 2 days before they may have said, I want X, whatever that is, you know, like a really nice car, like a BM or an Xbox or something like that, something they really wanted, suddenly now they think they always wanted what I got them. You know, and they're like, well, why would I want another car or an Xbox? That'd be useless to me. And suddenly this thing is useless to them because they're so delighted and surprised by what I got them that they forget what they originally wanted. Does that make sense? It actually replaces that memory.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Excellent, cool. Good, so you can have anything you like. What's your dream present?
A BMX bike.
A BMX bike?
Yes.
That'd be fantastic. And that would make you feel great, wouldn't it?
It would fulfill a childhood dream.
Really? Is it a childhood dream to have one?
I never got one when I was a kid.
You never got one when you were a kid, so it'd be great to have one. Okay. Do you want to have a look?
Yes.
Yes, excellent. Come and have a look. Ready?
Yes.
What colour is it? What did you have in mind?
Red.
Red?
Yeah.
Have a look. You want to grab that?
Good, nice and light.
Yeah. Let's just put it over here. Sort of thing you had in mind?
Yeah.
Yeah. Was this really a childhood dream to have one?
Yeah, it was.
No, you got all red.
I'm just amazed. I was just slightly odd.
I'm delighted. Well, happy birthday. I hope it's...
Thank you very much.
I don't know a lot about bikes, so I hope it's the right sort. And out of interest, what did you write originally?
I've got it with me if I still...
And what did you write?
I wrote a BMX bike, is what I wrote.
So when you came in here, you wanting a BMX bike?
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's probably not the case. If you can detach yourself from what's happened here a little bit, was it really a BMX bike you wanted when you came in?
That's what I'd written down, yeah.
You may have done, but that's very unlikely. Are you sure? If you think back, are you sure you're right? BMX bike is what you want. That absolutely feels right, doesn't it, when you think about what you want?
Yeah, absolutely, because that's what I wrote down, and that's why I'm so flabbergasted that it's there.
Take it out, have a look. No one's touched this, have they? Where's it been? Where's it been since you wrote it?
It's been in my wallet.
In your wallet. Go on, have a look.
No, even... I'm shaking.
Let's just have a look at the back. You signed your name across it.
Sorry, sorry.
This is the date and the time.
It was 1:10 on Saturday.
1:10 last Saturday, okay.
Yeah.
But genuinely, no one's touched this since you wrote it.
No, because I signed it over here, so you couldn't do it.
Let's just have a look. Leather jacket. Did you want a leather jacket?
No, I wanted a BMX.
So why did you write leather jacket?
I didn't.
You didn't write leather jacket. That's your handwriting.
That's my handwriting as well.
This is what you want.
This is what I want, yeah.
Right. Any idea why you wrote that?
No.
That gives you that feeling of spontaneous positivity.
Yes.
That. Yes? Not this. You don't want that. That's useless to you.
Absolutely.
So you're happy with your present? As am I. Congratulations and happy birthday again. Thank you very much.
Oh my God. I'm genuinely a bit freaked out. In a nice way. I came in here thinking, if I can suss this out, if there's some kind of thing going on that you know, I can work out logically, I'm just going to do it and, you know, I'm not going to be an arse about it. I'm going to play along and... But I'm stunned.
That's definitely my Ryan, that's my J, and I've got no need for a leather jacket, and I don't know what's going on. What's my name? He's gonna have me in a pickle jar by 2, I know it.
Okay, hold on to that. Okay, how much have you got? Count what you've got.
Hold that one. £30.
£30?
Yeah. £32.
Yeah, go on, keep it going. Yeah, £32.50.
£33.50.
Good for you, it's a lot of money. Have a look at what I wrote. £33.50. And I wrote?
£4.50.
£4.50. Which is wrong.
Yes.
Which means, after a hard day in doing this and not losing once, what are you going to spend it on?
Clothes, maybe. I don't know.
Clothes. Invest it wisely.
Thank you.
Very sensible. Congratulations, Zach. I'll get that off you again. No, do congratulations.
Fantastic. At first, I thought maybe I won't get the £100, but then when I got it, I was just like, oh, yeah.
So if you found yourself wanting a BMX too, this is probably why. Very nice to meet you and thank you for coming on the show. Let me explain to you how I buy gifts or presents for people, all right? And this is the best way to handle, bar none, the problem of, you know, what to settle for when you're gonna buy gifts for somebody that's a little bit difficult to buy for, all right? Now what I do is rather than recycle the same sort of two tired bottles of wine or box of chocolates, which are no fun to receive, I go out and I buy anything. And then I make that person fall in love with it, all right? By creating a strong feeling of desire for that object. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah. And it absolutely works. They get all sort of pumped up, you know? They get that feeling of that positivity you were describing. They beam excitement for it. And, you know, it's a win-win thing because they get a present that they love and, you know, I get rid of some stuff out the back of my kitchen cupboard or whatever. But what I want you to really understand about this is that that feeling is so strong, can be so extreme that it can replace the memory of what they actually wanted. So even though 2 days before they may have said, I want X, whatever that is, you know, like a really nice car, like a BM or an Xbox or something like that, something they really wanted, suddenly now they think they always wanted what I got them. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
Excellent, cool. Good, so you can have anything you like. What's your dream present?
A BMX bike.
Why do I have a sudden overwhelming desire to stick on a helmet and run red traffic lights? Strange. We saddle up and ride next tonight in Playing It Straight.
Later.